breakfast, Friday, August 25th, 8:30 at Bob Evans. This week, you'll be at Bob Evans for the men's breakfast that includes women, too. Yeah, okay. Also, this coming Wednesday night is Bible book study again. We are studying an exciting book at 6 o'clock. It's only for an hour. Pastor is leading it. It's a wonderful study. And you're saying, okay, but what's it called? Well, the book is called Where Do We Go From Here? Have you ever asked yourself that question? Where do we go from here? Well, this is a really good book, and that's what they're studying. This is a little bit in the future, but not much. The women's luncheon will be Wednesday, September 13th. I mean, before you know it, September 13th is going to be here. Because, you know, September 1st is just like a week out. So, put this on your calendar because it's going to be so good. It's the women's luncheon, September 13th, at the Corner Cafe. Everybody know where the Corner Cafe is, women? Sure you do. The Corner Cafe is right in with the Leland Hotel. Right in the Leland. Good, 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 good. You're going to love it. 12 o'clock from the 13th. Also, something to put on your calendar. Yeah, the women's ministry is having their craft bazaar again this year. So big and so nice. It's going to be October 14th, 9 to 4. Let me tell you something. All y'all need to do is just go to this bazaar, and you can complete your whole Christmas list right there. Now, do you like that or not? Okay, don't get too excited. Stay calm here. But this is great, though. You can get a lot of your Christmas shopping done. Beautiful things, absolutely. And if you need more information about it, see our little gal, Fran. Well, little gal, Fran's absent. Okay, see Fran or Joe Hughes, and they'll give you all the information you need to know about it. But it is October 14th. I saw the reminder up here, but don't forget about the Kingsmen being here, the Kingsmen Quartet. We'll be here on October 25th. I know it's out, but get it on your calendar because these guys are awesome. They have been in Spartanburg multiple times, and they are really good, which kicks off our revival, which begins on the 29th through November 1st. And that will be just as awesome and just as good. So think about attending that. I think there's only a couple more things, so be patient. Okay. Oh, yeah. Yes. I wanted to remind you about this. I'm sure all of you have heard of awful fires in Maui, just really disastrous. And in the foyer there, there's a piece of paper from Sue Blair where it tells about where you can go online and you can order some supplies and they will send it directly to Maui. You don't have to mail anything. You don't have to do anything except just go on this website, which is very easy to use, order the supplies you would like to order, and they will ship it. So, you know, anything that you can do for them would be just really good. I cannot believe how devastating that must be. Then the only other thing I believe is from our pastor. Yeah, he's excited. He would like to update everyone's address. And he took the latest, excuse me? Thank you. I knew it. I just want to know if he knew it or not. He took the latest directory and made a copy of it. And I'm going to put this out there in the foyer. And before you leave, if you would just kind of, you know, swing by there and look at your address. If it's right, just put a check mark. If it's wrong, then would you give us the correct address? We want to be sending things out, or we want to be able to contact you and know where you're at, okay? So this will be out there on the foyer. All you need to do is look at it, look at your address. If it's correct, check mark. incorrect, let us know what it is.
And if you're not in there at all, there's a page on the back. Write your name, your address, your telephone number on there. It's just a lined piece of paper. So if you're not in there at all, give me your information on there, please.
That would be awesome. So if your name isn't on here, that's no excuse. Put your name on a piece of paper with your address, and you're super. Okay, you know something we haven't done for a long time? You're ready to do this, because I'm ready to do this, and I'm excited today because the sun's out. It's going to be 90 degrees tomorrow, and that just turns me on and makes me so happy. God is great. So what I would like to do is have a motto today. We haven't had a motto for a long time, have we? Say no.
No.
Thank you. Okay, so our motto today is going to be Jesus is Lord. Jesus is Lord. Okay, so we're going to say that. We're going to say our motto really loud and just with a lot of emphasis behind it and just excitement. We have all kinds of things to be excited about today, do we not?
Amen.
The bizarre food, just being here. Just being here. So Jesus is Lord. We're going to count to three and say it real loud, all right? And believe it in your heart. I'm going to hear you believe it in your heart. Okay, ready? I know you are. I can see all the excitement rolling up. Okay, here we go. One, two, three.
Jesus is Lord.
That was super. Now let's do it one more time and really go for it. Ready? All right. One, two, three.
Jesus is Lord.
You
Amen.
All are awesome. I'm excited. Thank you. Let's go ahead and start our service. Lord, we just thank you for today, and we thank you for each one of the individuals out there that came purposely to be together and to worship you and to hear what our wonderful pastor has to say. We just love you. We're here because we want to be here. We're here to learn about you, to let you speak to us today. Keep us healthy. Keep us safe. Put your hand on all of us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. One other thing. In your bulletin, you notice if anyone is interested in being baptized, and I added in there because I had somebody tell me that they were interested in becoming a member of the church. So if you are interested in baptism or becoming a member, let me know. All right? And we can get that arranged pretty quick. So if you're interested in either one of those, let me know. All right? Y'all ready to sing? Y'all are just staring at me like, Let's sing. Stand with us as we sing. How great is our God this morning?
The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice. Trembles at his voice.
How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? And all will see how great, how great is our God.
Age to age.
How great
Hallelujah. How great thou art.
give Jesus a hand clap of praise this morning. I want you to hear what I hear. Ladies, let's just do it. I want you to hear this. Sing this. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Amen. Kind of what heaven's going to sound like, isn't it? You may be seated. Oh, man, he's good this morning, isn't he? Amen. Whew. I've never ran the aisles before, but I'm not against it. My God. Goodness. Ushers, come and let's worship with our tithe and our offering this morning. My Father, this morning we come before you with grateful hearts of just how great you are. Father, would you take this offering this morning? Would you bless it, Lord, for the upbuilding of your kingdom? Bless the gifts and the givers here this morning, and God will not fail to praise you, for you're worthy. It's in the precious name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Glad I am this morning, aren't you?
Amen.
So I don't know how many of you watch the birthdays and the anniversaries, but I noticed something this morning that, Patty, your birthday is Tuesday. But I also noticed your anniversary is Tuesday. Daryl, you were a genius. Yeah, got it all down at once. So be sure to wish Patty a happy birthday and them an anniversary this week. Stand and let's sing. We're going to go way back. I love this old hymn. And I told somebody, I said, if you like the old hymns and you like the new stuff, you're going to like this next set, all right?
How firm a foundation he saves all the to you. all my days I've held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, I have lived in the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful.
Thank you, Jesus.
All my life you have been so, so breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender. Everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. All my life you have been faithful.
Can you say that this morning?
All my life you have been so, so good. Goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God.
You want us to sing that chorus again?
All my life you have been faithful.
Praise his name this morning.
All my life you have been so, so. Breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God.
One more time.
All my life you have been faithful.
Aren't you glad this morning?
All my life you have been
well,
so,
glory to God,
so
she's been so good.
With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Can you say that this morning? All your life, he's been so faithful. Amen. Yes, praise God. Amen. 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 Okay. Amen. Somebody else this morning. Yes, amen. I'm glad. Amen. Somebody else this morning just want to sing of the goodness of God. As we go to prayer this morning, I want us to think about that chorus. Whatever you're dealing with this morning, whatever struggles you may be facing, He's been faithful, hasn't He? He didn't bring you this far to leave you now. And with every breath that I am able, I'm going to take all of my prayers and petitions straight to Him, because He already knows about it. He's already got it figured out. So just take and lay it at the feet of Jesus this morning. He has been faithful. He has been so, so good. Just take it to Him this morning. Some good news for you this morning. Ronnie Henson's out of the hospital. He's at the Springs doing a little bit of rehab for a couple of weeks, but he's already itching at the bit and fussing to go home, so God is moving there. Chris Clark is out of the hospital this morning. Resting. He didn't get much sleep the past couple of days he's been there, so that's where they're at this morning. But just one by one, God's just doing like He promised He would, keeping His hand on us. And I praise Him for that this morning. Bring your prayers and petitions to the Lord this morning. Let's sing that chorus one more time as we go to prayer.
All my life You have been faithful. All my life You have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Father God, this morning we come and bow before the throne of grace, knowing, Father, how amazing You are today. Lord, knowing that all You've asked of us is to bring all of our prayers and all of our petitions before You. And that, Father, You'd take those burdens and You would replace them with Your peace and Your joy. Father, we know this morning there's no better place for us to leave our burdens than with You. So God, You know each and every one. Lord, You know this morning the physical needs that are represented amongst this crowd today. And Lord, You know the spiritual needs, the financial hardships, the emotional needs, the mental needs. Lord, You know it all. And You have promised that if we would just bring all of that before You, Father, You would take care of it. May not remove the problem, but You promised You'd walk through it with us. And we thank You for Your faithfulness in that. We thank You this morning for answered prayer. Father, we thank You this morning for being a God who is not just sitting some far away on a throne, but one that comes and intimately deals with our hearts and strengthens us. We are so grateful for that today. Lord, in the remainder of this time we have together, I ask your blessing, Father. Father, I pray for the special music this morning. I pray, Lord, that as I bring the bread of life here in just a moment, you'd hide me behind the cross of Calvary. So, Lord, have your way in our hearts and in our lives, and for it we'll give you the highest glory, honor, and praise. And it's in the precious name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Well, it's one thing for Greta and I to get up here and sing a special for you. But another one of those dad moments this morning. When your girls ask if they can sing a special, and then they choose a song like this to sing. Let me just say this. If you're not blessed by this song they're going to sing, your wood's wet this morning. All right? Girls, come and sing. It's called The Promise.
Soldier. keep on walking. Don't turn to the left or right. And in the midst of darkness, let this be your light. That how can separate us, you're gonna make it through. This is the promise. This is the promise.
Amen. Yeah. Amen. I like that verse, that last verse. So just keep on walking. Don't turn to the left or right. And in the midst of darkness, let this be your light, that hell can't separate us, and you're gonna make it through. Whew! This is the promise I've made to you. Praise His name this morning. I tell you what, you walk out of here and you think that you just ain't been in the presence of God. You done missed something this morning. My word, hallelujah. I'm glad He passed by this morning, aren't you? I'm glad that He just said, you know what? I love them folks there at Richmond First. And I'm just going to come and I'm just going to minister to them and sup with them for just a moment or two. Isn't it great when the Holy Spirit just does that? I'm telling you, it's good stuff. Well, it's fitting. There is power in the name of Jesus this morning. It's like God knows what He's doing or something. I don't know. There is power in the name this morning. I got to thinking about that old hymn this morning. How many of you remember that? Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth, or joy of earth and hope of heaven, I think. Precious name, take the name of Jesus with you. Haven't sang that song in, I can't say 40 years, but a long time. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. There we go. Precious name, oh how sweet. There is such a power in the precious name of Jesus. Isn't there this morning? How many of you have found this? And maybe this morning you've just, you say, Adam, I know that. But life is happening and seems like everything's just crumbling around and I'm hurting in places that I didn't know I was hurting this morning and or even knew that could hurt this morning. You know, I know some of you, Karen said she was on the heating pad before she came to church this morning because of the pain and just different things. Greta, bless her heart, she's not being rude if you can't hear her this morning. She lost her voice. We were here for praise team practice last night, and by the time we got home, she was doing this. And she said, my throat is sore and all of that. And maybe this morning you just come, you say, Adam, I needed this today. I needed the Holy Spirit to come and minister to my heart. It's been not a bad week, but not a good week. You know, just kind of one of those middle of the road. Anybody ever have a middle of the road week where you're like, meh, it's all right. It's okay, you know. We all have those weeks. It seems like Overland asked me this morning, he said, how was your week? I said, I feel like I'm dragging my butt behind me. I've just been running and running and running and just all week long. And it seems like I blinked and here we are on another Sunday morning. And it's just been busy and hectic. And I was thinking that we would eventually settle into a routine. But so far it's just been, kind of like a squirrel on, I don't know, whatever, acid, I guess. Off the chain, you know, running here, running there. But I thought about how Satan comes in the midst of our trials. And how that punk is right there. And he's just, well, if God really loved you, he wouldn't be letting you go through this right now. If God really loved you, you wouldn't have more month than money. Amen? If God really loved you, you wouldn't be dealing with the heartache that you're feeling right now. If God really loved you, and you say, but I know he does. There is a time and a place, my friends, when you as a Christ follower need to realize that there is power in the name of Jesus. There comes a point in time when Satan's just relentless, going on and on, that you just need to fight fire with fire and start whispering. I don't care. You may say, Pastor, I can't even utter the name of Jesus. Just whisper it. Just whisper the name. That's all you have to do. Satan cannot stand when we tap into a power that's way beyond our own. He can't stand it. He can't stick around because he knows the true defeat that lies ahead. He knows what's coming. I want to read a very familiar passage of Scripture for you this morning. It's probably one of my favorite stories post-Jesus. Now, Jesus hadn't been gone very long. He had just ascended into heaven, and we pick this story up with Peter and John going to church. Everybody came to church this morning, right? Listen what happens here in Acts chapter 3. Now, Peter and John are going up to the temple at the hour of prayer, the ninth hour. And a lame man from birth was being carried, whom they laid at the gate of the temple that is called the Beautiful Gate, to ask for alms of those entering the temple. Seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, he asked to receive alms. And Peter directed his gaze at him, as did John, and said, "Look at us." And he fixed his attention on them, expecting to receive something from them. But Peter said, "I have no silver or gold, but what I do have, I give to you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Rise up and walk." And he took him by the right hand and raised him up, and immediately his feet and ankles were made strong, and leaping up, he stood and began to walk and entered the temple with them, walking and praising God. Whew, I'm going to get wound up this morning, folks. Just bear with me, all right? So here we are. We went to church this morning, and here's a lame man from birth. Peter and John saw him, and it says, What I find interesting about what happens here is that this man wasn't paying any attention to who was passing by him. You realize that? He was just sitting there shaking his little tin cup. We know this because they looked at him and said, "Hey, look at us." So this man wasn't really begging of anybody. He was just sitting there holding his cup. Wasn't specific. It's just when he knew somebody was coming, he shook his little cup and asked for money. And I love this because the disciples looked at him and they said, "Look at us." And it says, when the man fixed his gaze on them, Peter looked at him and he said, "Silver and gold, that's what you're asking for. I don't have any of that." Amen? "But what I do have." Peter goes, "What I do have, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. Now, you and I, standing by not knowing what Jesus had done, probably going, what in the world is wrong with you two? This man has been lame from birth. He's never walked a day in his life. Everybody else, when they walked by, they'd flip a quarter at him. They never did anything to help him. Other than just, well, it's a whole lot simpler, isn't it? Whole lot less time consuming. Just throw some money their way and give them what they want and move on. No, Peter and John said, you know what? I don't have any money this morning. They probably didn't. But they realized what they did have. And that was power in the name of Jesus. My friends, let's get a hold of this morning. Let's get a hold of this morning, that there is power in the name of Jesus to overcome any obstacle or trial or heartache thrown in our way. There is power in the name of Jesus. So Peter goes, we don't have any of that, but what I do have, what I know my God is capable of, I'm going to give to you. Get up and walk. And I love this verse. This next verse, it says, well, after a little while, his ankles and his feet gained strength, right? No. It says immediately his ankles and legs were strengthened. Then it said he leapt up and went running, shouting, and leaping into church. Can you not imagine? I mean, you just passed by him. You flipped him your dime. And then all of a sudden, here comes Joe. He's running in. He's walking. And you're going, wait a minute. Gene, wasn't that the guy that was just laying out there? He's been laying out there every Sunday. Wasn't that him? And you're going, well, yeah. And all of a sudden, that church whisper started. Wasn't that Joe? And everybody's going, what in the world? And it says he went running and leaping into the church, praising God for what had happened. You see, this is power way beyond what you and I can think of. It's way beyond what we are even capable of. Unless we call on it. Now hear me. Peter and John could have just flicked their coin at him, walked on in, and not thought another thing about it. But instead, they realized that they could change this man's life forever just by calling on the name of Jesus. Hello. Just by calling on the name. Well, word got around. All right? The word spread. And in Acts chapter 4, we read this. On the next day, their rulers and elders and scribes gathered together in Jerusalem with Annas the high priest and Caiaphas and John and Alexander and all who were with the high priestly family. And when they had sat them in the midst, they inquired, by what power or by what name did you do this? Then Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said to them, rulers of the people and elders, if we are being examined today concerning a good deed done to the crippled man, by what means has this man been healed? Let it be known to you and all of the people of Israel, that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead, by him, this man is standing before you well. This Jesus is the stone that was rejected by you, the builders, which has become the cornerstone, and there is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name given among heaven and given among men whereby we must be saved. I love this. Peter just flat stuck it right in their face, didn't he? He says, listen, we didn't do this. What was done is this man needed to be healed. He had laid there for however many years from the time he was born, and we gave him something that was beyond what any man could ever do. It was through and by the power of the Lord Jesus Christ and through that wonderful name that we gave him something, and that's why he stands here well today. That's why he stands here well. It wasn't anything that I could do. It's all about him. Oh, by the way, we did this in the name of Jesus Christ. You know, the one you hung on a cross, the one you crucified and thought you had gotten rid of him, but God gloriously raised him from the dead, and it's through his power that we did this morning. Ha! He was the stone that you rejected. That's who we did this through. There is power in the name of Jesus. This old world might come and say, well, you are absolutely crazy to think that there is anything in this God or this Jesus. Y'all are nuts. You bunch of Bible-thumping holy rollers, right? Let me tell you what Jesus has done for me. Let me tell you what that name has done for me, how it's brought me out of darkness, how it's brought me from death unto life. Let me tell you about Jesus and what's in that name. Oh, friends, this morning, this is something we need to grab a hold of. We need to grab a hold of this, especially in these last days. Let me just say, if you have not been coming on Wednesday nights, this book is amazing. It is amazing. It is literally telling us that what we're living through right now has been prophesied about. And I'm telling you, you need to come. If you are able, we would love to have you. If I need to buy more books, I will buy more books. I don't care. But we are having a blast reading this and realizing that what is going on, the Bible has already told us about. We need to grab a hold of this morning, especially in these last days. We need to grab on to what power is at our disposal. In Luke chapter 10, Jesus sends out the 72. Remember this story? And I love it because they came back almost baffled, Kay. They came back going, Jesus, even the demons are subject to us in your name. They were shocked. They said, Jesus, even demons are subject to us through your name. And he's going, yeah. What do you think I've been trying to tell you? Understand that I am just a representative of my Father in heaven. And all power in heaven and earth is mine and it's his and it's yours if you'll just tap into it. It's all yours. This is what I've been trying to tell you. Yes, the demons are subject. If you go over into Mark chapter 16, Jesus himself says, these signs will accompany those who believe in my name. They will cast out demons. Oh, Jesus said that. And they're shocked. Aren't we? When the old devil comes a-fighting and he's just doing his thing, and then we start to speak the name of Jesus, we sit there and go, wow, that's pretty cool. That's amazing. And then we come to church and we testify and we're going, praise God, all I did was speak the name of Jesus. And the devil had to flee from me this week. And your pastor's standing there going, duh. Yeah, and? We act like this is some newfangled idea. Jesus himself said that there was so much power in his name that we could cast out demons. Hello. You say, well, it's like there's just a demon chasing after me this week. Cast him out! Well, it just seems like he's there and won't leave me alone. Remember what Paul, and this is what baffles me. So many people read scripture, but they read over it. I have had so many people come and they say, Pastor, what was Paul's thorn in the flesh in 2 Corinthians? We don't know what it was. What was it? I said, it says right there. Paul says it was given to me a messenger of Satan as a thorn in the flesh. Paul had a demon chasing after him. He had a messenger of Satan. That's what a demon is. And Lord, take it away. Lord, take it away. Lord, take it away. No, no, no. But what I'll do is I'll give you my strength. My grace will be sufficient, and my strength will be made perfect in your weakness to deal with it. Call on the name of Jesus. There is power there. You say, Pastor, come on. This is all well and good. This is all in the book. You know, but we don't heal lame people in this day and age. We don't cast out demons in this day and age. What does this have to do with me? Well, thank you so much for asking this morning. You're such an inquisitive crowd. I appreciate that. What does this have to do with you? 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 11. Paul says, and such were some of you, but you were washed, you were sanctified, you were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and by the Spirit of our God. What does this have to do with me this morning? You were washed, sanctified, and justified through the precious name of Jesus. That's what it's got to do with you. You're here this morning. You're living a life that you're sitting there going, man, I am so blessed because of the precious name of Jesus this morning. Praise his name. What does this have to do with me? Well, the fact that you're sitting here. Right? Let me ask you a question. If it hadn't been for Jesus, how many of you would even be alive right now? Let's be honest. I'd probably be laying dead in the gutter somewhere. But Jesus. But Jesus. How many of you would say, Pastor, I may be alive, but I would be so spiritually dead because I would have walked away from it a long, long time ago? That would be me. But Jesus. Seems like when I call on him, situation may not go away, but my attitude sure changes. Seems like everything, all the gloom and despair and agony that I want to sing about just disappears. Because I have tapped into a power far greater than my own. Maybe what we need to learn is to quit bellyaching in the first place. Hello. Come on now. We need to stop bellyaching in the first place and say, you know what? I realize as soon as this trial starts, it's way bigger than me. It's way more than what I can handle. We like to say, well, God said that he would never put on me more than I can. That's not true. God said there will be no temptation come upon you that you couldn't bear. He promised that he would allow trials to come, but that he would take care of them. God may allow things to come our way that's bigger than us, but none that are bigger than him. There's power in the name of Jesus. So instead of bellyaching, how about we say, all right, Lord, I see where this is going. I don't like it, but I am trusting in Jesus this morning. I'm going to trust in you. Come hell or high water, come rain, come sunshine, come valleys or mountains. I don't care. I'm going to trust you. And I'm going to just call on the name of Jesus. How many of you have ever heard the name Nicole C. Mullen? Back in the 90s, she released one of the most bedrock songs of our faith called I Know That My Redeemer Lives. Whoo! You want to shout? You want to become a shouter? Listen to that song. But she also released in the late 90s another song called When I Call on Jesus. And the song says that when I call on Jesus, all things are possible. I can mount on wings like eagles and soar. I don't know about you, that sounds pretty good, doesn't it? That sounds so good. Give me just a second here, because I didn't think to do this before. I love the fact that we've got Google at our fingertips, but I hate the fact that, too. I want to read, because the verse, I don't want to mess it up, because she starts off saying that I'm so very ordinary. Let me get the lyrics here. lyrics. There we go. Yep. Isn't Google great? There we go. I'm so very ordinary, nothing special on my own. Oh, I have never walked on water, and I've never calmed a storm. Sometimes I'm hiding away from the madness around me, like a child who's afraid of the dark. But when I call on Jesus, all things are possible. I can mount on wings like eagles and soar. When I call on Jesus, mountains are gonna fall, because he'll move heaven and earth to come rescue me when I fall. I'm so very ordinary. You know, I love what David wrote in the Psalms. He said, I am poor and needy, and yet the Lord thinks about me. He thinks about me. And he says, you know what, Adam? I hear you. I hear the prayers. I hear you whining. But I sent my son to give you power to overcome. What are you going to do? You going to keep whining and complaining? Or are you going to tap into a power far greater than your own? You see, such were some of you, but you were washed, you were sanctified, you were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and by the Spirit of our God. And then Jesus promised this in John chapter 14. But the Helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send, what? In my name, will teach you all things and will bring to your remembrance the things that I have said to you. He said, I will have a Helper coming in my name, and he will teach you. He will help you to overcome. Man. Jesus said, I'll send somebody to help along the way. Just call on me. Well, this is all well and good, Pastor. But now what? Yeah, I realize that he raised the lame and he did all these great things, and I realize that he saved me, and I realize he sanctified and justified me. Thank God for that. Thank God for the Holy Spirit. But now what? Well, I want to wrap it up like this in Philippians chapter 2. Therefore, God has exalted him being Jesus, and bestowed on him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow in heaven and earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. This is where the rubber meets the road now. I want to bow now. I want to bow now and profess him as King of Kings and Lord of Lords. In my hardships, I need to bow. God has given Jesus the name that is above every name, and at that name, every knee will bow. Listen to me closely. You may say, Pastor, I don't feel like kneeling today. I don't feel like bowing. Guess what? One day you will. One way or the other, you will bow down and declare him King of Kings and Lord of Lords. One day you will bow down to the power that is his. I'd much rather do it here. Amen? I'd much rather do it here. I would much rather say, Lord, here is the situation in my life. I need you. Here it is, Lord. I'm done. I'm done fighting it. Maybe that's the thing this morning. Maybe you say, Pastor, I feel like I've just been fighting this battle for ages, and it just won't go away. Maybe it's about time you bowed down and just said, Lord, I can't anymore. But you can. There is power in the name of Jesus, and I am going to yield to that power and allow it to change my life. Do you remember when he first came in? How many of you remember when you first got saved? And how he changed your life? Isn't it amazing? Whoo, you go back and you start getting glory bumps. You're like, oh, that was a good day. Maybe the day you got baptized. Maybe the day that you accepted that second work of grace. That was a good day. But I am tired. There's power in the name of Jesus. For whatever you're dealing with today, there is power in His name. Stand with me this morning, and I want you to do something for me. Because I don't think any of us want to leave here dealing with the same garbage that we came in with. Anybody want to take that stuff home with you? Huh? I didn't think so. Would you just lift your hands to heaven this morning and say, Lord, here it is. I claim the power in Jesus' name. Overcoming all of my hardships, overcoming the situations in my life, there is power in your name, and I claim it. Mean that this morning. Mean that this morning. I claim that power. I'm going to walk in that power. I'm going to live in that power over the hardships, the trials, the situations, the doubt, the fears, whatever it is. There is power in the name of Jesus. God, today, would you help us, Father, to surrender all that we are and realize that you are so much greater. God, help us today to realize the awesomeness of the power and the precious name of Jesus. No other name given among men whereby we must be saved. God, today, you know each and every individual in this place today. You know what's going on in our lives. You know what's going on in our hearts. Lord, help us today to proclaim the power of Jesus' name over it. To walk in that power, to claim what's beyond us. Oh, Father, today, would you have your way? Help us to walk in that power this week. Help us to call on that power on Tuesday, maybe, when the old devil's coming and he's just fighting and he won't shut up. Lord, help us just to whisper the name of Jesus and watch him run away like a whipped puppy dog. Father, today, encourage us this week. Fill us with you so that, Father, we can stand in the mighty and powerful name. And it's in that wonderful and matchless name of Jesus we pray these things today. And all God's people said, Amen. You are dismissed. Go in power. With